Hello and welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC697CPM925 central processor. I have one powered up here in the rack, and the rack is an IC697CHS750 5-slot rack, which is empty otherwise. It's just a test on the processor, and it's being powered by an IC697PWR711 power supply, which I do have powered up right now. First thing I want to indicate to you guys, if you're testing your processor, is this LED here. I have the door off just so it's not distracting for our test, but the door has information on what these different LEDs are. First one is module OK, and mine is solid, which is good. So if for any reason you guys don't have this light on, or it's blinking and you can't communicate, then that means there's a large error, big problem with your processor, and you won't be able to follow those tests. You'd have to stop right now. That is something that we normally repair here at PDF Supply. We do offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something that you need, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Okay, so now that I am on and I am connected, I'm using here, for your reference, an ACE S693-232 SNP cable. I like this one particularly because it has LEDs you may or may not be able to see that blink as a user interface that lets me know the processor and the software are communicating. All right. And now about the software, I am connected through Prophecy Machine Edition. And first thing I'm going to do is click the, I am already connected, so I'm going to click the green handprint button, which is toggles me to program mode. All right. Okay, so that was successful. Next thing I'm going to do is on the top menu bar, go to target, go to online commands in the middle. And when that pops open, you want to go to clear. All right. Now, what you want to clear in this, you will need to do this to go any further. You want to clear a controller fault table and I/O fault table because your configuration being empty is going to be different than what it was before, and you need to clear those before you can go any further. So make sure that you do not clear any memory related items because you may lose something that you need. So just stick to the bottom two selections, controller and I/O fault tables. All right, clear those, okay. And the next thing is, once that's clear, go to the download and run icon, download information and run button. And okay, the first thing that comes up, it's asking us, what is it that we want to download? So again, just a simple test. Our goal is to get the processor into run mode, and all we want to download is controller, hardware configuration, and logic. So the top two selections, hardware configuration and logic, and then yes. And then it's going to build. I'm going through a build sequence right now, and then it'll allow us to go into run mode. Okay, and here we go. All right, we're in run mode now. All right, I know I'm in run mode because all three LEDs are on. All right, and going from the top, this is the top LED module OK, middle is run enabled, and bottom is run enabled with outputs enabled. And that allows us, this is going to help us to test the toggle switch first. There are no other ports to test on this processor, please note. So we just have this switch and then the memory protect. So in the uprightmost position, all three LEDs should be on. All right. We go to the middle selection on the toggle switch, and the outputs are disabled, but the processor still is in run mode. All right. And then we go to the bottommost selection of the toggle switch, and the processor is in stop mode. So we've manually stopped the processor, and the LEDs are telling us that it's stopped, and the software is telling us to stop. So we do know that this is working perfectly. All right. Next thing, of course, is we have a key here. Everybody knows the memory protect switch. This isn't always, sometimes we have a problem with it. It's not always an internal problem. A lot of times the switch will stop working. Okay, so ours is working, and we can tell because when we turn it to the on position, we have the memory protect LED turns on to tell us that that's functioning. That's good. and we shut that back off. So I'm okay with that. So typically, if we get this because they think that there's a field problem with it, or if you feel that this is a processor that's giving you trouble, and what we would normally recommend is that you leave it in run mode, just like you see it here, overnight or over a weekend, a couple, 2-3 days, something like that. And what you're trying to do there is that you want to see that the processor is able to hold itself in run mode for, you know, a couple days. And if for some reason it pops out of run mode, if it fails, then there is some sort of a problem, some sort of a fault. What I would recommend is you go to Prophecy Machine Edition while you're still connected and go to your target in the top menu bar, then go down to Diagnostics. Click on Diagnostics and your info viewer screen will pop up with a fault table, and it'll tell you exactly why it popped out of run mode. It'll give you the errors. Sometimes the errors, depending on if you click on them, they may be written in codes and be hard to understand. A lot of times we do get very useful information from it, so I do recommend that you check there if you have a problem. And then if it's still something that you can't get past, or it's beyond the scope of what you want to do to repair it, then please see us. We do repair these quite often. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and we do offer same-day shipping. So please keep us in mind at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.